Hey, art friends, today we are going to draw Frankenstein.
Yeah, we're going to draw a folding surprise Frankenstein. When you open it up, you can see his brain getting electrocuted. It's going to be awesome. We hope you're going to follow along with us. You need something to draw with. We always like using markers. You also need some
paper
and
something to color with.
Yeah, you ready to start?
Yes.
We're first going to take the top edge of our paper and line it up with the bottom edge and crease it, fold it down the middle. Yeah. Then we're going to take the top flap and fold it back up to the top edge and then crease that one down too. Good job. Now we're going to flip our paper over and we're going to repeat that step. We're going to fold the flap back up to the top and crease it down. Then we're going to take that last fold and unfold it and flatten it out. Then we can flip it back over. So it should look like this. It should be able to open up like that. Next, we're going to take a scratch piece of paper and put it underneath our drawing paper. This protects our table while we're drawing. Sometimes the marker will bleed through the paper and get onto the table. You don't have to use a red piece of paper. You could use whatever scratch paper you have at home or in your classroom. You ready to draw Frankenstein?
Yes.
Let's first draw his nose. I'm going to draw it just below the fold in the middle of our paper. I'm going to draw a U shape, kind of a wide U shape. Yeah, then we're going to draw a little C on the left for one nostril and a backwards C over here for the other nostril. Now let's draw his eyes. I'm going to draw a circle on the left side of his nose and a circle over here on the right side for both eyes. Let's also draw a smaller circle inside each eye and you can color it in. This is for the pupil. Then we can draw his mouth. I'm gonna just draw a straight line underneath his nose. And we could also draw cheek lines on each side. Oh, and let's add two teeth. A little U for one tooth and another U for the other tooth. All right, we got his face. Now let's draw the shape of his head. We'll start over here on the left, and just at the fold, we're gonna draw a line that comes down, and then we're gonna come across for the chin, and then we're gonna come back up and stop at the fold. It's a wide Frankenstein head. Next, we're going to extend the head up past the fold, and we're going to come up towards the top of our paper. We can do the same thing over here on the right side. Then we're going to connect these two lines up at the top over to the other side. Next, we're going to draw a zigzag line for his hair. So some of the zigzags could be small and some could be big. You don't have to draw them exactly the same or even like mine, you could draw them different. Good job. All right, now let's draw his ears. We draw a C next to the left eye and a backward C over here next to the right eye. And then we could also draw the inside of the ear with a little curve on each side. And then he also has those little bolts sticking out of his neck. So we'll draw a line that comes out, down, and then back in. And we could do the same thing over here. Come out, down, and then connect back into the cheek. Now we need to add the little stitch line that goes across his forehead. This is where his head opens up and you can see his brain. So I'm gonna draw a straight line that goes across or on top of the fold. So you wanna draw, you can do it twice if you need to, or a couple times. You want to make sure that when you open it up, you can see the line up here and also down here at the bottom. Yeah. Then you can go over it again so that you can see it on the top too. Now let's draw the stitches. I'm going to draw little short lines going the other direction across the fold. Man, that looks so cool. Now let's add one more little detail. We could draw a curve underneath each eye. Kind of makes him look tired or more like a zombie.
I think zombie.
Yeah. We did it. We finished drawing our Frankenstein head. Now we're ready to open up our paper and we can flatten it out so that it's easier to draw on. Let's draw his brain right in the middle of our paper. Now this, you don't have to make your brain look exactly like mine, but I'm gonna draw little bumps going across, and it's in the shape of an oval. Some of the little bumps are, some of the bumps are big and some are smaller. Yeah, that's awesome. Good job. Now we can draw the face on his brain. Maybe I'm gonna draw a circle over here on the left and also on the right. I'm gonna draw little pupils inside. We can also draw him screaming, the brain screaming. I'm gonna draw a C shape. And we can draw the tongue coming out of his mouth. So I'm going to draw, kind of looks like a sideways raindrop. Good. And then down here at the bottom, we can connect up to the tongue. And then we're going to imagine that going behind the tongue and connecting up to the top of his mouth, or the brain's mouth. And then we can color in the bottom shape and also the top shape. Now let's add electricity to the brain. That's what makes him come to life. So let's draw a zigzag line, and yours doesn't have to look exactly like mine, but the one thing you want to remember when doing this step is to make sure that you draw everything below this fold and everything above the bottom fold. That way when you fold up your paper like this, it's hidden. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So you want to make sure that the electricity doesn't go over the folds. So you can draw a little zigzag line starting from the brain going up to the corner. Yeah, and then let's draw zigzags coming back to the brain, but we'll leave a little space here. Let's do the same thing over here on this side. Draw a zigzag that comes out to the corner. And then we can come back towards the brain and then stop. Let's repeat that same step down here, but go to the lower corners. Then we're going to add the same thing over here. We'll start close to the brain. Add a zigzag that comes down to the corner. And then right here at the end, you can draw a zigzag coming back to the brain like that. Yeah, all right, now we got the lightning bolts coming out. Let's connect these two lightning bolts at the bottom so we can add a zigzag line that connects the bottom. And then we can add that same zigzag line up here at the top. Oh, and then also let's connect the left side and the right side. Let's say one more thing to make his head look more three-dimensional. We're gonna add a curve right here that comes down and then comes across and connects to the lightning, with electricity. Then let's do the same thing over here, draw a line and then curve it into the electricity. Now let's draw the same shape inside. Might be a little tricky, but I bet you can do it. I'm gonna first draw this line up here at the top. And then over here, we'll draw the same shape that comes down and connects to electricity. And then the same thing over here too. Now let's repeat that same step down here, except we can just connect all the way across. I don't think we need to use any overlapping behind the electricity since we have more space here. But if you guys at home, if you have electricity that comes down further, you can do the same thing that we did up here and overlap. Yeah, all right, now let's draw the inside. I'm gonna draw first a line that comes across. It matches the stitch line. And then we can repeat the same shape around the back. We did it! We finished drawing our Frankenstein with the brain getting electrocuted.
But we still need to color it.
Yes, this part we're gonna fast forward, but at the end you can pause the video if you wanna use our drawings as inspiration to color your drawings. You ready to fast forward?
Yes.
Mrs. Hubbs, we did it! We finished coloring Frankenstein. I love your drawing so much.
Thanks.
Now, he looks really cool all put together, but let's take him apart.
Okay.
You ready? 3, 2, 1. Happy Halloween! Now, you guys can pause the video right now to match our same coloring.
Or you can color it any way you want.
Yeah. You could also add extra things to the folding surprise. I added little squiggly lines to the brain and also highlights, but you can leave that off to keep the lesson a little easier.
We hope you had fun drawing your Frankensteins with us.
We do. We hope you had a lot of fun, and we hope you have a happy and a safe Halloween. And we'll see you later, our friends.
Goodbye.
Boo!